Very good evening, all of you guys. Let's start with today's session. Quick recap, in yesterday's session, we discussed about the tool JAVAC, then the tool Java. Then we started with some elementary programming things, like what is an identifier, identifier naming rules. Then we discussed about keywords also. Right, guys? Keywords, and then I gave you the set of Java keywords, all the Java keyword list I gave, right? And then I told some keywords which are not in use, but still Java has kept it reserved. Then there are some keywords which have value also, like true, false and null, right? And some keywords which are not in use, but still they are reserved, like go to and const, okay? And then we discuss some keywords of C++ but not in Java, some of C++ but carried in Java, then some keywords which are specially of Java only, right? Now continuing all that discussion, we'll come to the next concept, that is comments. Okay? So what do you mean by comments? And are comments ignored by your compiler? Compiler never checks comments. What you have written with what you have written in that comment, never compiler checks it. Comments are all ignored by the compiler. Comments are text for documentation purpose. The whole sole purpose of comment is for documentation. Means to make your code understandable to you only later or to someone else. When someone else is going to work on your code, if suppose you have developed something and later after some years on that project only some other team is going to work, so by reading the comment they should be able to recognize what is the purpose of that comment, that code. And suppose you only after some time you are seeing the code, so the comment will be helpful for you, right? So comments are for documentation. Like to tell who is the author of that code, the date when it was created, what is the purpose of it, okay? Then somewhere functions are there. So it tells about what that function is doing, what it is taking input as, what it is going to return, some formulas are there, or some complex calculations. So the explanation of that you can give it in comment. Now, what all types of comment Java support, that I'll tell you. But what is comment? I hope you got it. Okay, they are the text. It's a text, but that text is always ignored by the compiler. The comments always ignored by the compiler. The whole sole purpose is for documentation. Getting to make your code become more readable for you only in the later stage or for someone who is going to work on your code. Right? Now, Java supports three types of comments. We'll discuss all that. The first one is single line comment, which they have borrowed from C++. It is called as a C++ style comment. Okay. Slash slash. Actually, this comment is from C++ and it is carried in Java also. Any line which starts with slash slash, so till the end of the line, till the line doesn't get over, everything is ignored. It is treated as a comment, right? Then this is coming from C++. Always say C++, don't say CPP, okay? So C++ is having this single line comment, slash slash. Then from C, they have borrowed multi-line comment. That is slash star, because this cannot extend to more than one line. And if you want to write comment more than one line, so for every line beginning you have to put slash slash, a tedious task. Therefore, they have introduced a multi-line comment called slash star. Now this can extend to any lines, getting? And till star slash doesn't come. So slash star indicates the beginning of the comment, and the moment you get star slash, the comment is over. So everything within that is ignored by the compiler. Any lines of code and any text you write, everything is ignored by the compiler. This you'll learn more in detail when you learn compiler construction in your last semester. You have one subject called compiler construction. There you'll come to know, okay, okay, how internally compiler ignores all this thing. And Java has introduced their own comment. These both comments are carried from different languages. Java has introduced their own comment called documentation comment, which starts with slash double star and it goes till star slash. Means till star slash doesn't come, it's a comment, and it starts with slash star star. This is called as a documentation comment. This is specially introduced in Java. But you'll say, what is the speciality between this multi-line and this comment? In this comment, that is a documentation comment, you can use these special @ tags. Okay, they are called as documentation tag, which start with @. Means within this, you can write like this, @ author. Getting? And then the name of the author. @ param. Params means parameters, which you can put just above the method. So there are many such tags, many such annotation tags are there. You call it as annotations also, @, and then many are there. There are list, all this at this moment I cannot tell you. For example, I told @ author, then @, getting, params, and many more. Now still you'll say then, but still what is the speciality? So Java has given you one tool in that Java doc, sorry, that Java development kit, JDK. So from that JDK, two tools we have used. One is Java tool, another is JavaC tool for compilation and for execution. There is another tool called as Java doc. Getting? I'll give you a separate demonstration on it, don't worry. So Java doc is a tool, and to that tool you'll give your source file in which comments are there. Like you're giving first dot java. This file I have given to this tool, and in this file there are these documentation comment like slash double star star slash, in which there are special annotation tags. Getting? Now what this tool does is, it takes this Java file, from that it will read all these documentation comment, and it will make and give you one HTML file, and that file acts like a help file. If you open and see that file in the browser, you'll see a proper document file, help file. If you see some online helps, you can see. So all these annotations which were there, they will come in a separate separate headings like H1, H6 size, and then below that some explanation. Clear? So it will create sort of a help file for your source code. So it is going to read all such documentation comments, and from that it will construct and give you one help file, which is a HTML file, and you can open and see that HTML file in the browser. Very attractive way they create and give you a HTML file, which acts like a help file. But that is made and given to you by Java doc. But Java doc reads which comment? Not a single line comment, not a multi-line comment. Java doc reads only which comment? These separate documentation comment. Getting? So doc comment demonstration I'll give you separate, don't worry. But remember that Java has provided such documentation comments also. Get it? Okay? So what are comments, that is clear to you? What is the purpose of it is clear to you. First, a single line comment which starts with slash slash, and till the end of the line it is a comment. Second is a multi-line comment which starts with slash star and it ends with star slash. Any line you can write. Once it begins with slash star, so after that till star slash doesn't come. So it can be one line, 10 line, 100 line. Till star slash doesn't come, it is a comment. So that much part your interpreter is going to ignore. And I said there is a third comment called as a Java documentation comment. A documentation comment which starts with slash star star and star slash. But in this you will have a special annotation tags like @author, @params, and many more are there. Okay. And what is the speciality of this documentation comment? If you give your source file to a tool called JavaDoc, JavaDoc is a tool. It's a tool provided in your Java development kit. So to that tool, if you give your source file in which these documentation comments are there, so it will read that doc comment and from that it will build and give you one HTML file. And that HTML file acts like a help file. If you open and see in the browser, it looks like as if it is telling the help of all your whole code. Get it? So that HTML file is built from that tool. But that tool will only read which comments? Documentation comment. And that tags which I told you, that annotation tags, they are also seen in a separate highlighted form in your HTML page. Okay? So I hope the concept of comments is clear to you. Okay? Now just tell me, can we say this is a valid multi-line comment? I'm writing slash star. Then something is there. And afterwards, I'm again starting with slash star. Something is there. Then I'm writing star slash. And then again star slash. What do you say, guys? Is it a valid comment?
Yes, sir.
Sure? Okay. Many are saying yes. What about others? From 200 students, only 15 students joined. Very pathetic. Student don't want to learn free also, see, height of education. No, why there is a pause? I'm expecting answer. Okay, Sanket is answering.
Sir, you can elaborate that thing because my earphone was lost the voice, so hello.
May I you're saying that, explain me again which part? This
multi-comment.
Means I'm asking, is this a valid comment? My question was only that can we write such comment slash star, then you have some text. Again, you are starting with another multi-line comment and you are completing with that star slash. After that, some again line and then star slash.
Yes, we can write it, but between two multi-line comment also can remove, na? Because we are giving whole comment, na? The whole code.
Okay. What about others? Any others' opinion? Sanket is saying valid. Shreya, Rutuja, Snehal, Abhishek.
Sir, I think it is not valid because if we are starting from slash star and again we have to close it with same.
Okay. So she is saying like, once you have started with slash star, so you'll close with star slash, right? So when this star slash comes, there only the comment is closed. She's saying like that, here the slash star comment started. Now after that, everything is ignored. But it will ignore till it doesn't get its corresponding closing. So which it gets it here. Do you agree, guys? You get star slash over here. Slash star, and then you get star slash. And here the comment is over. So this much part remains incomplete. You understanding? And it will give you an error. You can try doing it. Clear? But at least
yes, sir. Yes,
in
sir.
Proper direction
yes,
she
sir.
thought of in that direction. Okay? So it is not allowed. In short, can we conclude that nested multi-line comments are not allowed? What do you say? True or false?
True.
True. Clear? Nested multi-line are not allowed. Why? Because from here it starts with a comment and it is going to ignore everything till it doesn't get its corresponding closing. So where it gets its corresponding closing? Here only. Means after slash star everything is comment. So this slash star is also comment. And when it gets a star slash, which is a corresponding closing for that opening, here it gets a closing. And here only the comment is over. So this much part will remain incomplete. Getting? And therefore it will create an error. You can check it. You can write a program and try to compile it in which such comment you have written. Getting? So I hope you agree with me. ठीक है तो nested multi-line comments are not allowed.
Yes,
now coming
sir.
To the next concept, that is literals. What do you mean by literal? Okay, so literals are also called as constant values. Don't confuse with constants. Constants is different and constant values is different. ठीक है तो you can call it as literals or constant values. Now what do you mean by it? Okay, so they are the values which represent themselves. Constant values are, or literals are values which represent themselves. As they represent themselves, that's the reason it's called literal. Normally in English we say na, ki that person is literally like that. Literally like that meaning, as you see, that person is like that only. The same way, what value you see, it is that only. If you are seeing 4.5, it is 4.5 only. Nothing hidden. Get it? And that's the reason it is called literal. Means it is literally 4.5 only. Like if it is a variable, so it is representing whom if it's a variable? What is stored in it? Do you agree or no? If it's a variable, so it is going to represent what is stored in that variable. So what is stored, we cannot judge it now. By seeing the variable, can I guess what is stored in it? No. But by seeing the literal, I can tell. Because literals are values which represent themselves only. So if it is 4.5, it's going to represent 4.5 only. You understanding? So what are literals? I hope you got it. The literals or constant values are values which represent themselves. Okay, or they are the values which never change in the code. They remain constant. Values which never change. Means throughout the program, that value is going to remain as it is. Getting? So throughout the program, that value is going to remain same. So now if I write A equal to 3.14 into R into R, in this context, okay, that 3.14 is a literal. Why? Because it is a constant value. It is a value which represent itself. Clear? Means value which is representing themselves. And it is a value which never change. Means throughout the program, 3.14 is going to remain 3.14 only. It's not going to get modified. You understanding? No? Clear? Then there are different types of literals. We'll be discussing that too. But what are literals? That is clear to you. So literals denote constant value. constants are different. Constants are like variables. Means they take memory. They have some name. Only the thing is, in that memory, what value you keep, you cannot change it. So constants are something else. Okay. The constants are created using final keyword in Python. Sorry, in Java. So you have to use final int max equal to 10. Means it's like that. It is a variable sort of thing. Means memory is occupied. The name to it is max. Okay. And the value stored in it is 10. And once you store it, now you cannot change it. Get it? So that is like variable. Like if it's a variable, only the thing is variable also take memory. They have data type. They have their data type. They take memory. But the value in that memory can change. You can modify. Whereas here you cannot. So these are variable. These are constants. And I am talking about literals. Literals means constant values. The values which you directly use in the program. The value which is representing itself. The value which will never change throughout the code. Getting clear? Now there are different types of literals which Java has provided. I'll tell you about that. So what is literal is clear. It denotes a constant value. The value it represents remains unchanged throughout the program. Whatever value it is representing in my whole program, that value will remain as it is. Okay. Then few literals which are there in Java. Like there are some numeric literals coming in whole number category. Like I've written 6, I've written minus 45, I've written plus 2345. These are literals only, but they are integer literal. In that only there is a long literal, but integer category in which you attach L to it. We are going to talk more on it now. So 7L, so it's an integer literal but long. And these are by default int literals. Okay, then we have floating point literal like 4.5 or 2.3F. These are floating point literal. Then we have character literal. Getting? Put in single quote. Then we have string literal. Then we have Boolean literal, which is true and false. The speciality of these two literal is they are literals also. Literal means they are representing some value. Getting? But they are keywords also, means they are reserve words also. Getting? Then null is also a literal used to represent null reference. Means when your object is not having a reference, it will have null reference. Okay? So these are few literals which are provided in Java. All in category wise we are going to learn. Don't worry. According to the category, we'll learn all this. Okay? See. So first is integer literal. Example, I have put 2000, 0, minus 7. They are all integer literal. Then we have floating point literal. Floating point means numeric value only, but that numeric value is having decimal part. Scientific values, 3.14, minus 3.14, 0.5, 0.5. Character literal, which is any single character put into single quote, enclosed in single quote. Now the problem of your batch is you are learning in the same semester Python also, you are learning PHP also, and you are learning Java. See, three different genre languages you are learning, getting in one semester. So it is a task to you guys. You have to keep all the languages in that compartment. Don't mix up, don't mess up with it. Don't try to bring the rules of PHP somewhere in Java, Java's rules somewhere in Python. Getting? Why? Because every language is having its rule. Right? Like in Java, character and string are different. But if you go to PHP, if you go to Python, their char and string are not differentiated. They both are same. Getting? So I will not confuse. Now as we are learning Java, we'll focus on that only. So character literals are there. Then Boolean literal. Boolean literal means true and false. Then we have string literal, means anything written in a double quote, like double quote ABBA, double quote 3.14. okay, and then we have null reference also, which I've meant null literal also, which I've not put here. Get it? So hope it is clear to you guys, right? Then quickly some MCQs we will answer. Which of the following is not a legal identifier? Okay, I'll give you the list of it. Select the one correct answer. What do you say, you guys? Which one from this is not legal? Is A to Z legal? Yes. Why? Because it's following the naming rule, isn't it? What do you say? The naming rule is followed.
Yes, sir.
Three numbers.
Yes, only number three. Second is also valid, though that O is having two dot above it. Yesterday only we have discussed. Though that O is having that two dot above it. So, okay, we cannot type it through our keyboard, English keyboard. But instead of that, can I use the Unicode of that character?
Yes, sir.
Clear?
Yes, sir.
So according to Java rule, in your identifier name, Latin letters are also allowed. Yes or no? So therefore,
yes,
this character is allowed over there. Only third is why invalid? Because it is starting with digit. Isn't it? Fourth is valid because it's starting with underscore and then class word. It's a legal word. CA dollar H. Dollar is allowed. Total dollar is allowed. Currency signs are allowed. Yesterday we have discussed. So you got it. Why third is wrong? Then which statement is true? Okay, select one. I'm listing all the statements. Now, normally in your exam, only one they'll give when they'll say state true or false. Okay, so 6 points we have written, and from this, which one is correct? Okay, and which one is wrong? So only one is true, all other are obviously false. Okay, all are false except one. Coming to the first one, see, new and delete are keywords in Java. No, in Java only new is a keyword, delete is not. Whereas delete is a keyword of C++. In C++, we have delete as a keyword. New is also there. Obviously, in C++, we have new. Delete also is there in C++. But in Java, delete is not there. Can anyone tell me the reason why in Java, delete they have not put? If you have seen the table yesterday, the keyword table, in that whole keyword, nowhere delete was there. But delete is there in C++. Delete is used to release the memory which you have allocated dynamically. So to allocate memory on heap or to allocate memory runtime on heap, you use new. And to give that memory back to the system so that system can reutilize it, we have to use delete. So in C++, why delete is there? Because in C++, garbage collection
collector
means garbage collection. Just tell me, is garbage collection automatic?
No, sir.
No. Clear? In Java, garbage collection is
automatic.
Means, is there one low priority thread called garbage collector which is part of your JVM? It's a part of your Java virtual machine. Is that garbage collector a low priority thread periodically called after every fixed interval? Is it called after every fixed interval? The garbage collector is called. And what does garbage collector do? Check how many objects are there whose ref count has become zero, and those objects whose ref count is zero, it will put it into free list. So why Java is not using giving delete keyword is clear to you. The reason is in Java or garbage collection is how the garbage collection is done?
Automatic.
As the garbage collection is automatic, you don't have to explicitly free the dynamic memory. Getting? And therefore, there is no need of delete. Therefore, first statement is false. Coming to second, try, catch, and thrown are keywords in Java. So remember, in Java, try and catch is there. Thrown is not there.
False.
either throws is there or throw is there. Only throw or throws. There is a difference between throws and throw. We will discuss, don't worry. Now just remember, thrown is not a keyword. Therefore, false. Coming to third one. Static, unsigned, and long are keywords in Java. In Java, static is a keyword, long is a keyword, but unsigned is not. As we have it in C, do we have unsigned and signed keyword, which are called as type qualifiers? They are called as type qualifier. Means, can I write only character? Can I write signed character? Can I write unsigned character? These are called as type qualifiers. Java says some data types are strictly signed and some are strictly unsigned. So no need to explicitly tell whether it is signed or unsigned. In Java, there are some data types which are by default what? Signed. And there are some data types which are by default unsigned. You don't have to explicitly tell that it is signed or it is unsigned. And therefore, when Java says, I have classified already that these are by default signed, these are by default unsigned, no need to put explicitly that keyword as you do it in C++ or C. Getting? Therefore, unsigned and signed keyword is not there in Java. So this third statement is also false. Coming to fourth, exit, class, and while are keywords in Java. Again, in this, class and while is a keyword. Exit is not. Getting? Whereas exit is there in some languages like PHP. Here, remember, exit is a method of system class. I hope you remember class system. We have used in the first program system.out.println. So
yes.
You know system class, which is in lang package. Is it present
yes.
in java.lang package? Yes.
Yes.
So system class is there. And in that system class, there is one static method called exit, to which the termination code you'll give. So exit is a method. It is a static method in which class? System class. Why I have to call it a static method? Can anyone tell me why I'm calling this method as a static method?
There is no need of object to invoke that.
Yes, clear. Or you can say you have invoked it directly in the context of class. See here, I've called exit, but to call it, I have not created an object. Did I call it directly in the context of class name? Yes or no? And that's the reason. So what she said is right. So we have invoked it directly in the context of class name. And it is a method. Therefore, you cannot call it as a keyword because it is user defined. Someone has, some people have developed system class in that they have added this method and given us. You understanding? Means if I don't use this line in my program and if I create a variable exit equal to 100, will it generate an error or will it allow? Will it create a variable with the name exit and have value 100 in it?
No,
what do
sir.
You say? No? Think again.
It will create error.
It will create error or it will not?
It will create, sir.
Sure. Think again. Clear? Or same way, if I create my program, your class, okay, test, and in that I have written one method public void foo, and inside that I have created one variable main equal to 100. Getting? And I am writing system.out.println main. What do you say? Will it create a problem? Will it create a variable main of type integer and store 100 in it?
No, sir.
No, it will give error.
Yes.
Why?
Yes, sir.
हाँ, इफ यस एंड इफ नो, व्हाई यू थिंक इट विल गिव अ एरर एंड व्हाई यू थिंक इफ इट वोंट गिव अ एरर? एनी वन, इफ यू नो आंसर यू कैन टेल मी. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल टेल मी, इज मेन अ कीवर्ड इन जावा? डज इट कम इन दैट 50-51 कीवर्ड्स विच वी सॉ यस्टरडे? इन दैट सेट इज मेन अ कीवर्ड?
नो
नो. क्लियर? यू आर ओनली टेलिंग नो.
नो
मीन्स इज इट अ यूजर डिफाइंड कंपल्सरी फंक्शन? इट इज अ
यस
कंपल्सरी फंक्शन एज अ एंट्री पॉइंट, मीन्स फ्रॉम वेयर योर एप्लीकेशन विल स्टार्ट. ओके, तो इट्स अ कंपल्सरी फंक्शन, पब्लिक स्टैटिक वॉइड मेन, बट द नेम इज नॉट वॉट रिजर्व्ड, गेटिंग? एंड देयरफॉर कैन आई क्रिएट अ वेरिएबल विद द सेम नेम समवेयर एल्स? 100% वैलिड, यू डू इट. क्लियर? इट
यस
वॉन्ट
इट विल
क्रिएट
बी
अ, यू अंडरस्टैंडिंग और नो? एंड इन सम अदर प्रोग्राम वेयर आई क्रिएट सम अदर कॉल्ड एज बेस्ट, एंड इन दैट आई क्रिएट मेन, एंड देयर आई क्रिएट अ ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ दैट टेस्ट एंड आई कॉल फू. विल इट वर्क और नो? आई क्रिएट टेस्ट टी इक्वल टू न्यू टेस्ट एंड देन आई कॉल टी डॉट फू. विल इट वर्क? You are creating a
यस
copy of test class, then you are calling t.foo.
यस यस
It
सर
will
यस
go
सर
there, it will create a variable, it will print it. So the same thing I am saying for exit. Is exit one method in a system class? There is a class called system, which we have not created. Sun has provided. But is there one method with the name exit, which takes one exit code called as a status? Inside that, there is a logic to terminate your program. Means they have written a logic to kill your program. Terminate. Your program is going to get terminated when you call exit. But tell me, is this exit a reserve word or is it just a method defined by this Sun people in this class system? And now, somewhere in my program, this part we have not done, this part Sun has provided in lang package. But in my program, I'm directly calling system dot exit. Right, guys?
यस सर
ठीक है. तो कैन आई क्रिएट सम अदर फंक्शन विद द नेम सिस्टम? विल इट क्रिएट एनी प्रॉब्लम? मीन्स हियर
नो इट
ओनली, हियर ओनली इफ आई क्रिएट पब्लिक void exit, ठीक है, which is not taking anything but it's doing something. Is it legal? There is a exit function in system class, but you have created a exit in your class also. Will it do or no?
यस सर
Yes. So
यस सर
that's what. So that is only my question, because this is not a reserve word.
कीवर्ड
Clear? You got it. So fourth point is also false. Now coming to fifth. What do you say? Return, go to, and default are keywords in Java. Yes. Return is already a keyword which they have carried from C++. Default is the return you use in functions to return something back to the caller. Default in a switch case. And go to, yesterday only I told you. It is no more use in Java for go to. I mean, what is the purpose of go to in C? In C, when do we use go to? To transfer the control from one point to another?
Yes.
Getting? You might have not used it because it's highly discouraged. They say it's a poor coding. Using go to, we create a spaghetti code. Getting? It's highly discouraged, but there is a concept now of go to. Like you can say go to some label, and then at some point there is a label and some code. So control is transferred there. So for this purpose, can I use this go to in Java? No. Because Java says there is no concept only called go to and transferring the control from one point because it's a poor coding. Okay, Java is not allowing that go to, but still Java has kept it as reserve because the misuse of that word go to should not happen by the programmer. Getting? So what they are doing is they're saying, go to, you cannot use it for the go to purpose, which was there in C, C++, in Java. But still Java has kept it as what? Reserved. So was it there in the keyword set yesterday which I gave?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? It was there in that keyword set. I hope it is clear. Okay. So return, go to, and default are keywords. Hope clear to you. And obviously, if this is true, the last one has to be false, because from this six, only one is true. So the sixth one, can you tell me why false? Because in that there is a word next, and next is not a keyword in Java. For is a keyword, while is a keyword, next is not. But there are languages which have next as a keyword. Like if you have heard about VB.NET, okay, which is derived from the older Visual Basic, which is derived from the older Basic, QBasic, GWBasic. So in that they use next. So next is a corresponding word of for. Means in that, no, whenever they write a for loop for something, so they close that for with the word next. Correct? So in that language it's present, but not in Java. Okay? I hope it is clear. And tell me about this last one so that we can move to some more things, more learning process. So is this a complete and legal comment? Okay? See, I have written slash star, slash slash, and star slash. Okay? Select one correct answer. Three options I have given to you. Okay? The first option is saying it is not legal. No, it is saying no, this is not legal, because they are saying the block comment. The block comment end is getting commented because of this slash slash.
The second statement will be true.
Okay, but what about the first one is clear to you? The first one is saying that the block comment is not ended. Because they are saying that this slash slash is putting the star slash in a comment, is not ended, since the single line comment comments out the closing part. But do you think that this slash slash is going to make this star slash as a comment? Or is this slash slash only in comment because of this slash star? Because of this slash star, is this slash slash considered also? Or is it put into a comment? Means what I'm saying, is your interpreter going to consider this slash slash? No. Interpreter means your Java compiler is going to consider this slash slash? No. It is already in a comment because of this slash star. You're understanding? Okay. So it is completely valid. The slash slash part is ignored by the compiler. This slash slash is already ignored by this beginning slash star. So question only doesn't arise that this slash slash is commenting this part. Okay? And this combination of comment is illegal and the compiler will reject. No, it is valid. Okay? So I hope you agree with me. Okay.
Yes.
Now
yes,
what
sir.
We'll do is we'll yes, see sir. All the types of comments. All the comments one by one we will discuss. The literals. Whatever literals are there, all the types of literals we'll discuss one by one. Okay. See you. Integral literal we'll talk about. First type of literal. Then there are data types also we are going to talk. Data types in detail will be seen. Then what is the range of each data type, then how they get internally stored, all I'll tell you, don't worry. Now just understand who come under integer literal category. Now literal means what, that you know? Literal means constant values, or values which represent themselves, values which remain fixed throughout the program, values which never change in your program, values which are representing themselves. Now in integer literal category, all the numeric values which are whole numbers, numerical values but whole number. Whole numbers means you know, which is not having a decimal part. They all come under this category. Which category? Integer literally. But before that, which data types come under integer category? That first I'll tell you. In integer category, byte data type come, short data type come, int data type, and long. According to Java, sometimes by mistake I'll say according to Python, because just before this I have to teach. When this batch start, before that I take Python batch. So sometimes by mistake I can tell, but please understand it. Okay, I hope you can understand me. So integer category, these four data types are there from Java point of view. So Java says in integer category, integer means whole number category, byte come, short come, int come, and long come. But by default, the literals are integer. Default variables you can make of type byte and short. Okay, but the value, literal value. You understanding? Like I am creating one equation A equal to 45 into something, B into C. In this equation, is there value 45? Yes, it is a constant value. I hope you are understanding. It is a constant value and it comes under integer category because it's a whole number. This value is by default integer. Okay, and if you suffix it, suffix means at the end, you're attaching L to it. If you're suffixing to it L, that L can be small l, capital L. Small, capital doesn't matter. But if you are suffixing L, then it is long. But there is no provision to tell that it is byte or short. Data type can be byte or short. Means you can create a variable of type byte. You can create a variable of type short. You're understanding or no? But the literal value, that literal value is also having a data type. So what is the default data type of the literal which come under integer category? In integer category, whatever literals come, they are by default integer. See here, 45 into B into C. So what is the data type of that 45? Default integer. And if you suffix to it L, then it is long, and that L can be small or capital, both allowed. It is long, and there is no provision to tell that it is a byte literal or a short literal. Don't try to apply your super intelligence. Clear, you'll put B or S and you'll say it is a short. No, Java doesn't give any provision for telling which literal. I'm not talking about variable. Variables you can make of all four type. I'm talking about the literal. The literal can be by default integer unless and until it is suffixed with L. Okay, now this point is clear to you. Next is this integer literal, which is int or long. By default int, L attached, long. You can represent it in different notations. The default notation is decimal. Okay, now decimal, why? Because it is base 10. Base 10 means in its number system, there are 0 to 9 numbers. Means in its number system, there are how many numbers? 0 to 9. Means total, how many numbers are there in that number system? 10 numbers. And as there are 10 numbers, each digit place value will be in power of 10. Getting? And it cannot start with 0. That is the rule. Okay? Cannot start with 0. And combination of what? 0 to 9. And each digit place value is power of 10. That's the reason you call it as base 10. Meaning, if I have written one number like 462, So tell me, are these all three numbers, the 2, the 6 and 4, from that 0 to 9 number system? Is it from that 0 to 9 only? Yes or no? Is it from that 0 to 9 combination? So is it a number created from the 0 to 9 combination? Yes. Is it starting with 0? No. Therefore, it is coming under which representation? Decimal. And as it is decimal, its each digit place value will be in 10 power. 10 power 0, 10 power 1, 10 power 2. See, 10 power 2 is 100, 100 into 4, 400. Yes or no? 10 power 1 is 10, 10 into 6 is 60. 10 power 0 is 1, 1 into 2 is 2. Yes or no? Units, tens, hundreds and all. I'm not going into two basics. You have studied all this in your school days. Okay? So that is one representation called as decimal. Then Java allows you to represent octal notation also. Why this decimal? I hope it is clear to you. Yes or no, guys? In its number system, how many digits are there in that number system? 10 digits are there. Which are the 10 digits? 0 to 9. You will create a number from the combination of 0 to 9. From 0 to 9 combination, you will create a number. Okay? And whatever number you create from that combination, like you are creating 456, you are creating only 23. So all these numbers which you have created, 456, 23 or 1234L, means in long form, these are integer form, they all are created from this 0 to 9 combination and they are not starting with 0, and therefore each digit place value will be in 10 power, 10 power 0, 10 power 1, 10 power 2, 10 power 3. Clear? Coming to octal system. Now octal system is base 8. Base 8, why? Because in its number system there are only 8 digits. Which are that 8 digits? 0 to 7. Is 0 to 7 total 8? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Total 8 digits are there in that number system. And it should start with 0. In other languages like Python, it is 0 over. But here only 0. It should begin with 0. And that's the reason I wrote over here, cannot start with 0 in case of decimal. Because in case of decimal, if you start with 0, it will be automatically treated as octal. And that's the reason decimal numbers cannot start with 0. Like here, before 456, if I put 0, it is no more 456. It will not treat it as 456. It will treat as octal 456, whose decimal will be something different. Getting? Okay. So I hope you got it. Octal means base 8. In its number system, there are 8 digits. And you'll create the numbers from that 8 digits. All the numbers place value will be in 8 power. Getting? So suppose I write 35 over here. But I have to write 0, 35. I'm writing 0, 2, 3, 4 or 0, 1, 0, 1. So 0, 1, 0, 1 means it's not 101 of decimal or it's not 5 in binary. It is 1, 0, 1 in octal. Please understand. So if I write 0, 35, it is octal 35, which is 29 in decimal. You can do and see. Why? Because each digit is in 8 power. So 8 power 0 is 1 into 5 is 5. And can you tell me 8 power 1 is 8 into 3 is 24, which will give you 29. Right? So is this 0, 35 in octal, 29 in decimal? Yes. Or here I have written 0, 1, 0, 1. But I have started with 0. Therefore, it is treated as octal. So it is going to be 65. You do and see. 8 power 0, 8 power 1, 8 power 2. Is 8 power 2 64? 64 into 1 is 64. And the last is 1. So the total is how much? 65. Clear to you guys? Yes or no? Just give me confirmation.
Yes, sir.
Sure?
Yes,
then
sir.
The third number system is hexadecimal. Now, hexadecimal means it is base 16. Meaning, in its number system, there are 16 digits. And using 16 digits, you form a number. Whereas here, octal number you form by using this 8 digits. You use this 8 digit and you form a number. Is 35 formed from that 8 digit? 101 is formed from that 8 digit. Here, this 10 digits you use and you form a number. So here, there are 16 digits. But now you'll say 16 means when I'll go to 10, it won't be a digit. It will be a number formed with 1 and 0. So here what they do is 10 they represent as A. Means some alphabets they have used. So 0 to 9 and A to F. But that A to F you can write in uppercase also allowed. And it should start with 0x. That X can be capital also. You understanding? Getting guys? Okay. So here I cannot give you each and every detail on the slide. I'm trying to explain it. But still, if you want to read a book, there is my ebook also available. I'll share you the link later. A detailed ebook is there. It's a complete Java book where proper in detail explanation I have told you everything. Clear? So if you want, I'll give you the link. You can view that book also. Hexadecimal is base 16. So in that number system, how many numbers are there? 16 numbers are there. How you get 16 numbers? 0 to 9 is 10 numbers and A to F the next 6. 0 to 9 will be 10. Then A, sorry, you what I wrote Z, it is F. Very, very sorry. It's a blunder. Clear? Very sorry for that. It is A to F only. Yeah? Because total 16 are there. No? So 0 to 9. Then A will be treated as 10, B is 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. So 0 to 15 makes 16 numbers only, I hope. Okay. And these all numbers start with 0x. So now tell me if I write 0x35 or I write 0x101. Will it be different value? Yes. Now, the same 035, I am writing as 0x35. Is it 35 only in decimal? No. Is it 29 in octal? No. Then how much it is in hexadecimal? You can do it and find out. Is it going to be 53? Tell me, 16 raised to 1 is 16 into 3 is 48. And this is going to be 5. So 48 plus 5 is how much? 53. So it is 53 in decimal, which is 0x in hexadecimal. Same case if I write 0x101. Is it 257? Just check. 16 raised to 0. And here it is 16 raised to 2. No need of taking this 0 because it's going to get multiplied with 0. 16 square is 256 plus 1 is 257. Do you agree with me or no? Correct? Yes, guys. And the last is your binary notation, which is introduced from Java 1.5. Before that, there was no facility of binary literals. Huh? Before that, Java was not giving binary literal. Understand, guys, carefully. After Java 1.5, in 1.5 and onwards, they introduced this new concept called binary literal. Okay, now binary means it is base 2, means in its number system, there are only two digits, that is 0 and 1. Getting guys? 0 and 1, only 2. So all the place values will be in power of 2. Like here, each digit place value is 16 power, 8 power, 10 power. So here it is 2 power. And how to recognize it is binary? तो स्टार्ट विथ जीरो बी, जीरो कैपिटल बी इज ऑल्सो अलाउड. नाउ दिस इज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन सी ऑल्सो, लाइक लेटर सी स्टैंडर्ड्स लाइक C99 एंड ऑनवर्ड्स. इन सी ऑल्सो दे हैव बॉट इट, ओरिजिनल सी वॉज नॉट हैविंग. ओके, तो नाउ टेल मी इफ आई राइट जीरो बी 1101, इज इट टेकिंग एज 1101 और इज इट 13 इन डेसिमल. सी आई रोट 0B1101, करेक्ट. एवरीथिंग इज टू पावर ना, टू रेज टू जीरो, टू रेज टू वन, टू रेज टू टू, टू रेज टू थ्री. Getting? Now, donkey work you'll do, 8 plus 2 is 4, 8 plus 4 is 12, and this one is 13. So you can take it. Other ways, what? Always remember, in any binary number, if I is your binary number, and to that if you attach 0, it becomes double. That is the speciality. To any old binary number, if you attach 0, it is going to become double. And to any old binary number, if you attach 1, it's going to become double plus 1. You understanding, guys? If you attach a 0, it will become double. If you attach 1, it's going to become double plus 1. So understand this. See how you can find out that it is 13 only. Tell me, first is 1, right? But when I attach 1 to it, what it will become? Will it become double plus 1? Yes, guys. It was initially 1. I attached 1. Will it become double plus 1? So what is double of 1? 2. And 2 plus 1 is 3. So this is 3 now. Now I attach 0. Will it only become double? 3's double is 6. To that, if I attach 1, will it become 6 double or 6 double plus 1? 1 is attached, no? So it is double plus 1. So 6 double is 12 plus 1 is 13. That simple it is. So there is no need of doing what thing, lot of calculations and all. Getting, guys? Correct? Like if I give you any value like 10011. Okay? So no need of doing 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1, 2, 3, 4 and then doing it. You know 1. When you attach 0, double, that is 2. When attach 0, that is 4. When attached 1, so it is 4 double plus 1, that is 8 plus 1, 9. And 1, so 9 is double plus 1, which is 18. Getting on? 18 in 19, very sorry. And you can check it, it is 19 only. 2 raised to 0, 2 raised to 1, 2 raised to 2, 2 raised to 3, 2 raised to 4 is 16. This is 2, 18, and this is 1, 19. Okay, so these are all basic things. In the final year, I don't have to teach you all this, but I hope you got it. And finally, one point I want to tell you. To all this, you can precede sign as well. Okay, to all the above notations, sign can be preceded. That is plus or minus, or you don't give the sign. Getting? Means I am writing minus 045, or I am writing minus 0x2d is legal, or I am writing plus 56 explicitly, or I am not writing only 0x bad, all are valid. So to all the notations, or even for binary also, if I write minus 0B11011 is legal. So what you'll remember, in all these notations, what can be preceded? The sign as well. Okay, guys? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
ठीक है, Good, very good. Now let's continue. We'll just read this, whatever I taught you. So who come under integer literal category? I told you. Comprised of the following primitive data type like byte, short, int and long. These are the four data types which come under integer category. But can I create a byte literal? Can I create a short literal? Is it possible?
No.
No. You can create a variable of that data type, but literal you cannot. So what is the default integer literal?
Long.
Default.
Integer.
And unless and until you attach what? Unless and until you suffix what?
L.
Clear? So at the end when you attach L, then only long. When you don't give, it is default integer. See here. Default is always integer. But it can be specified as long by appending. Appending means at the end. Attaching what? L or small l. Okay? And no direct way to specify short or byte. Variables of that type, but literals you cannot. Okay? Then different representations are there. One is decimal, which is default. How to recognize it is decimal? Any sequence of 0 to 9, any combination of 0 to 9, but it should not precede with 0. Because if it precedes with 0, it treats it as octal. Okay. Now tell me, if I write a literal like this, 049, will your Java give an error?
No, sir.
No, think again. You don't think and yes, someone is telling. What do you say? Will it give an error?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Why do you think it will give an error?
Start with 0, that means it is octal, and base of octal is 08. That means we have to value between 0 to 7 only.
Yes, very exactly she told. So perfectly she said. Getting? The concept is too clear to her. See here, what she said, in such a proper flow, she said, as the value starts with 0, it is octal, and octal can have only value between 0 to 7, then how can it have 9 in it? Getting or no? So Java will give an error. It will say it's an invalid octal literal. Because in octal literal, 9 cannot come. You understood? As the value start with 0, according to 0, the computer will treat this value as octal. But in octal number system, only the values are 0 to 7. 8 digits are there. Means only these 8 digits you can use and create a number. How can 9 come in it? It will give error. Okay? All these are very basic things. Right? Then the second come, that is octal. Octal is any sequence of 0 to 7 but preceding with 0. Then we have hexadecimal, any sequence of 0 to 9, A to F, getting small a, upper A, and preceding with 0x or capital 0x. And the last is binary, which is introduced in 1.5 and onwards. In the previous versions, binary literal was not there. They had not given, they added it later. So it is any sequence of 0 or 1 but preceding with 0b or 0 capital B. And to all these representations, let it be decimal, octal, hexadecimal, binary, you can precede it with a sign, that is plus or minus. And to all this you can attach suffix L also. All, let it be decimal, octal, hexadecimal, binary. All can have suffix L. See here, I've written 0x bad and then I've written L. So it is a hexadecimal number but long. Understanding? And you can have a preceding sign as well. Valid. Okay? Hope it is clear to you. Now we will move to floating point, but before that just tell me one example I'll type. Just tell me the output of it. Now this is our program. We will come to the next program. Suppose I'll give literal demo. I'll give the program name as literal demo dot java. Okay, I'm going to save it in that folder only, literal demo dot java. I'll create a class literal demo. Now with this, please don't make conclusion. You people start making conclusion that whatever is the file name, you have to give the class also the same name. It is not such mandatory rule. But good practice, why? Why to give the same file name and the class name same? Because the moment you compile it, when you'll run, you'll give the same name only. No? Why you have to remember the another name? Get it? So good practice is we give the same name, but it is not compulsion. Huh, when it is compulsion, if I make it public, okay, see here, public static void main string args, and in that I'm just writing one statement system dot out dot println, and I'm writing 101 0101 0x101 and 0b101. Okay, and I'm trying to compile and run. Okay, before that, you people tell me, what do you think? Will it be an invalid statement and it will give an error? Or will it add that and give you the final decimal answer?
Final decimal answer.
So what, final decimal. What should be the final decimal answer? Instead of typing, compiling and running, you do it mentally. Do it mentally, okay, orally. Mentally means you got, no? Just in your mind you try to, or you can do a rough work, but don't directly type, compile and tell me the answer.
It will not give error, sir.
That is okay. So many told it will not give error. So if not, to what it will give you?
It will display one integer value.
So what is that answer? That's what I'm asking. What will be that answer? Okay. Someone is telling. 4. Sure, think again.
421. Wait, addition.
Okay, do the addition. Now, can you tell me 101 means 101 only, the first one? Is first one considered as decimal 101?
Yes, sir.
Clear? The first one is, that is 101. But the second one which I wrote, it was 0101. So it is octal. So 8 raised to 0, 8 raised to 1, 8 raised to 2. So 8 raised to 2 is 64 plus 1 is 65. So will it take 65? And the third is hexadecimal 101. Today only I showed you hexadecimal 1. 16 raised to 0, 16 raised to 1, 16 raised to 2. So it is 256 plus 1, 257. Is it right? Okay. And the last is binary 101. Can you tell me binary 101 is how much? This is 1. When I attach 0 double, that is 2. And to that 1 I attach, the double plus 1 is 4 plus 1. That is 5. So it is 5. And when you add it, how much do you get? 12 and 6 is 18.
428.
Clear? It is 428. And this is 4. You can run it. See here. I'll run it for you people. Okay. CMD. I'll go to D drive. Then CDTY. Okay. Then JAVAC. And I'll write literal demo dot java. Java literal demo. Clear? I gave a spelling mistake. no issues. Is it printing 428?
Yes, sir.
Yes, clear. Now suppose in this only, if I write system dot out dot print ln 0x bad, what do you say? Is it valid 0x bad? Is it a valid integer literal?
Yes, sir.
Yes, so what should be the answer? Don't compile, type and run and tell me. 0x bad if I take B A D. Is it 16 raised to 2? So 16 raised to 2 is 256. Right? Into 11. Right? Plus, this is 16 raised to 1. That is 16 into A. A is 10. So 160 directly. And plus last D. Correct? That is 13. You add it and you'll get it. Like multiplying anything with 11. There is a direct Vedic trick. If you want, you can go to my YouTube channel. You'll see one video. Is it 6, 1, 8, 2? 160 and plus 13. So how much it will be?
2,989.
Clear? Now if I compile this code, sorry, then I'm running that code. I didn't save it, remember. That's the reason. Is it giving 2,989?
Yes.
You should be able to do it. I hope you got it. Right? Then quickly what we'll do, we'll cover up with floating point and then we will stop for today's session. Okay? So we'll come to the next one, floating point literal. Now floating point literal means they are also numeric literals only. Number literals only. But they are not whole numbers. Means they are having some recurring decimal part, the fractional part after dot. Clear? So when the numeric values are not whole numbers, but they are numeric value and they are having recurring fractional value, then we call it as floating point. Now who all come under this category? Okay, here only I'll explain. There are two data types coming in this category. One is float and another is double. Like in case of integer, I told, in case of integer there are four data types according to Java. One is byte integer, byte data type, short data type, in data type, long data type. By default it is integer. When you suffix L, it is long. No provision of byte and short. Get it? Similarly, in floating point you have float and double. Default, it is double. Default, double. Please understand. If I write 4.5, many think it is float, but it is double, default. If I'm writing 0.000456, it is double. You're understanding, guys? Correct? It is,
yes, sir,
a double value. It is not float. But the speciality of Java is, like in C also it is double only. In C also if you write 4.5, 0.00, these are double values. But Java has given facility that you can suffix D also to it to explicitly tell that it is double. There is a provision to suffix D. That D can be written capital D also or small d, but both allowed. When you don't write, then also it is double. And explicitly if you put D, it becomes more assertive. Confirm you are telling that it is double. Getting now? Anyone who reads 4.5D, they know it is sure double. And this is assumed double. When you don't write D, it is assumed that it is double. Okay? And if you suffix F to it, it becomes float. Suffix F. then it becomes float. See, 4.5f, 0.000456f. That f can be capital F or small f. So unless and until you suffix this f, it is double. Getting? So by default it is double. If you suffix f, it is float. If you want, you can explicitly put d, which is also considered as double. Right, guys? Okay. And how you can represent it? Like in case of integer, we had four different notations: decimal, octal, hexadecimal, binary. Remember, floating point values cannot be represented in binary, octals and hexadecimals and all. That is to be represented with 0 to 9 combination only. But there are two notations. One is called as a fixed notation. Okay, fixed notation, in which you write digits. Okay, first you will write digits, then dot, and then again digits. Means as it is, you are not doing any normalization on it. Means you are not normalizing your value. As it is, you are keeping it. Means if your value is 0.00062. So like in school days, like school means in 11, 12, when our readings used to come too small or too large. So we were told to write it in a normalized form. No? Normalized form called Mentissa exponent. I hope you remember Mentissa exponent. So that form we are not writing. Okay, so that becomes a fixed notation. Digits, then dot, and then digit. And there is a scientific notation. Okay. Now what is that scientific notation? So that is writing this number only in a normalized form. Means you bring this dot to the first digit, first non-zero digit. Like this is 6. So I'll bring this dot here and I'll write 6.2 into 10 raised to minus 4 because it is shifted right side. Same way the number can, the dot can shift to the left side also. But how we write that scientific notation? So we write Mentissa first, then E, that E can be small or upper, and then the exponent part. First the Mentissa part, then the E, and then the exponent part. So same number 0.0062, when I write in scientific form, I'll write 6.2 E minus 4. Okay, right? So 6.2 is the Mentissa and minus 4 is the exponent, which is same as 6.2 into 10 raised to minus 4. It is same as 6.2 into 10 raised to minus 4. Means if I write 1E3 and I am writing 1000.0, it's same. Do you agree? If I write 1000.0 and if I write 1E3, is same or no? 1E3 is same as 1 into 10 raised to 3. So 1 into 10 raised to 3, 10 raised to 3 is how much? 1000. Getting, guys? And to both the notations, let it be fixed notation, let it be scientific. To both notation, you can suffix what? D or F. To both the notations, that D or F can be attached. Okay? Quickly we'll see and then we will take hold for today. See here. So floating point literal, two data types come under this category. One is float and another is double. Then I said default is double. But still if you want, by default it is double. So it is assumed double. But if you want to explicitly tell that it is sure double only, you can suffix D. Suffix means at the end you can attach D. Prefix means at the beginning. So you can say prepending and appending. So capital D or small d. And can be specified as float by putting the suffix capital F or small f. And here also there are two notations. One is fixed notation, which is digits dot digits, digits, then dot, and then digit. And another is scientific, where we write Mentissa, exponent, Mentissa, then E, and then the exponent. Okay, and to both the notation, the preceding sign can be there as usual. as usual to both the notation, preceding what can come? Sign can come. Okay, so quickly just tell me, are these all examples equivalent? Means is 0.0, 0.0d and 0d, R3 all zeros only? 0.49,
yes.
Only 0.49, 0.49d are same. 49.0, 49.49d are same. Same way, can you tell me 4.9e1, is it 49 only? 4.e into 10 raised to 1, no? So 10 raised to 1 is 10. So when you multiply 10, it becomes 49 only. Getting guys? So all three are same. Same way, tell me 4900 e minus 2 is same as 4.9? Sorry, is same as 49?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Why? Because it is 10 raised to minus 2. Means it will divide by 100, which will become 49 only. Same 0.49e2. Means 0.49 is multiplied by 100. So it will become 49. Getting? And examples of float. Are they all same float values? Are these all same? 4.9 into 10 raised to 1. 4900 into 10 raised to minus 2. 0.49 into 10 raised to 2. Are all three representing 49 only, guys? Yes. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. The concept is clear to you people. Right? Then in the next session, some other remaining literals are there, like Boolean, then string literal, the character literal, all that we'll discuss. Okay?
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
So for today,
yes,
we'll
sir.
Stop all of you. Thank you all of
Thank
you.
Thank you, sir.
Please take care.